We got the Robert Downey Jr. CD.
Now, why is he even...
And
he's
have...
not known for music, is he, over the years that he's been in the public eye? Has he ever put out any type of music?
Nope.
Well, he's had a tough life, and now he's singing songs about it, and people want to hear his songs.
They do?
Unfortunately, I can't find it here. There's so many CDs around. I don't know which one. Oh, here we go.
It really is a bevy of CDs.
Another self-important jackass who thinks just because he had a tough life that everyone wants to hear him warble about it to music.
Well, Liz
warble.
Smith.
That was warble. Great.
That's a great word. It's a great word.
Fucking great.
Liz Smith is in the paper today.
Yuck.
Ranting and raving about the new Robert Downey Jr. CD.
She liked it?
She likes it a lot.
Figures.
Yeah, that does. She wants to stay close to the Hollywood people. She never has a bad word to say about anyone unless they're really on their ass and can't help her.
Some dullard just rambling about his own pain. We all got it. Stupid.
And you know something? It might be good if he was a good singer.
Right.
And if, let's say, he was a good songwriter.
Mm-hmm.
And if he wasn't a jackass actor beforehand.
Oh, he's a great actor.
You want to hear... Yeah, I know, but he's a jackass. You want to hear a good guy writing about his pain and stuff, pop in a Nirvana album.
Yeah, he did it well.
The guy did it well, did it right. It was entertaining and sounded good.
And he's a singer. He should have been doing it.
I mean,
Cobain should have been doing it, as opposed
right.
to...
So, the Robert Downey Jr. CD, Anthony. So, he's got a CD out.
CD? Well, I can't wait to hear some of it.
And Liz Smith in the paper today, she writes, "Tonight, I urge you not to miss Robert Downey Jr. on The Tonight Show performing Man Like Me from his first studio CD, The Futurist."
Oh, he's doing it live?
On The Tonight Show?
Get a copy of that.
He gets The Tonight Show, Jimmy.
Well, me and him both.
That's true.
Some of the songs on this record were co-written by Downey, and these clearly autobiographical. I know.
I'd have called it Downey Syndrome. Wouldn't that be a fun name for an album?
It's when you're born retarded because fabric softener got caught in your vag.
These clearly autobiographical ballads reveal a rich, introspective talent.
Dopey haircut smells spring fresh.
His voice.
Can't sleep unless he's being put in a circle and it's really hot.
Jesus.
Could you put your son in my clothes? I have static cling.
Lick the clothes with that fat tongue.
His voice.
And then you do what you normally do when you're dull. You just throw it out. Because it's garbage.
Jesus. Are you insane?
You're insane. Anthony, his voice is romantically raw, deep, and full of emotion.
Romantically raw? That's called no singing talent.
Deep and full of emotion, and when he gets to the Charlie Chaplin classic Smile,
what?
With its call to smile through your heart is aching, smile even though it's breaking. Well, this brilliant actor who has seen his ups and downs knows the material.
Would you rustle up some courage and shoot yourself in the head already? Well, like any normal guy that's been through all this crap would do.
We got samples of Robert Downey Jr. singing.
Ooh. Let's give it a little listen.
This is the one he's going to perform on The Tonight Show. It's called Man Like Me.
This is a habit I'm breaking now forever. I'm weary from trying to shake it. So when I ask if you won't give me your hand, I'll take it right now from your mother. She says you're throwing life away.
Did he rhyme take it with I can't remember what now because it was 5 seconds ago?
Make it, break it.
Oh, he just fucking
fake it.
Stinks.
What did he rhyme? Was it ridiculous?
It was something with take it.
This is a habit I'm breaking now forever. I'm weary from trying to shake it. So when I ask if you won't give me your hand, I take it right now from your mother's side of town. She says you're throwing
turn it off?
All right, I will.
I love that. Raw!
It was Shake It.
Shake It and make
raw,
it.
Raw, raw vocals.
He's terrible.
He's doing that affected voice thing. Forever! Like, no one talks like that.
If I may, he sounds like Bruce Springsteen with a friggin' tracheotomy.
You're yeah.
Right. It's horrible.
It's got that, yeah, it's sort of a Bruce Springsteen, at the beginning of it, almost
little,
Neil Diamond-ish.
A little Dylan, too, right?
Dylan.
You hear the bad Dylan, too?
Yeah, the bad notes are definitely Dylan influence.
No, that's not bad notes. That is raw, like what's-her-face yeah. said.
First Liz of all, Smith, she yeah. should be killed by getting caught between a train and the platform, fat pandering whore, and he should be singing Julian Gives Good Head and Is Dead over and over while he's pelted with pumpkins. An overrated fuck.
Ah, that's good.
Another sample. This is
not
broken.
Right? Maybe that was just the bad one.
Backup group Ambrosia.
That one was recorded while he was passed out in a child's room. So that's where the echo you get is actually the big kid room with a little crib in it.
Too bad she didn't fall in love with a broken CD. You wouldn't have to listen to this. Stop it, heart on the sleeve, asshole.
Here's
you get
a
it.
Sample
you're hurting.
Of the title track, The Futurist.
Sage the world. Sounds like October. A futurist knows. I'm curious, curious. Venus is cold.
What?
There's a
key. Oh, they already.
Got out there. You know how this happens, by the way? He's humming in the car one time and he sings. And the wormy L.A. assistant goes, yeah, really a good voice, just because they're wormed. They don't know what else to say. And he'll go, really? You think so? And then they realize, oh, shit, I have to perpetuate
you
this with more.
Make a CD.
Yeah, I always thought you were a good singer. And no one.
Oh, Mike nailed that one.
Can tell them that they stink.
Mike nailed it. Go ahead, Mike, from Baltimore.
That sounds like bad fucking Corey Hart.
That was Corey Hart.
Surrender.
Remember Corey Hart? Wow.
Surrender.
Surrender.
Yeah, I remember that stupid song. Good job.
All right, thanks.
All right, yeah, Mike nailed it. And I don't even know what this one's called. Kimberly Glide or something like that?
But it's about being hurt.
Kimberly I bet. Glass, in the
arms of cactus angels. What?
My own big shots float around. Guess this is her home now.
Her arms are cactus angels? Did he fucking say that?
And now this is a Bruce Hornsby type of vibe.
Oh, good. Oh, he's so groovy.
This sounds like any demo from a local shit band.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds
right.
like.
But he gets to do it on The Tonight Show.
She should take her cactus arm and put it right in his ass, and I'm sure he'll be a little bit of a better singer.
I saw him like 2 months ago on some talk show. I think it was Conan.
Yeah.
And I guess that was when he was thinking about doing something.
I'm thinking
that.
The audience probably, woo! Yeah, you should do it.
Like crazy tonight.
And now it's going to be, well, here he is in a different, kind of a different thing than you used to see him in. Great. Fast Freddy.
Yeah.
Play the autobiographical future classic, Fucked in the Ass at the Big House. Maybe his prison life has inspired him.
Todd from Kansas, go ahead.
God, he makes... Yeah, he makes Clay Aiken sound like Pavarotti. Mm. God, I'd much rather stick an ice pick in my ears.
You know, sir, look, I'm not a comedic genius, but I do know that when the first one bombs, don't tag it. Just let it go.
Yeah, he slapped a little tag on that one, hoping it would sell
ice
it.
Ice pick in the eye. That was like the fail safe.
Yeah, oh.
Stuart from Florida.
Ice pick in your throat before you call us, man. Yeah.
Go ahead, Stuart.
Yeah, the only thing that'll make this CD worth listening to is if at the end we get to listen to him drown in his own cum.
Wow.
People are a little angry.
And finally, Anthony, this is the song that Liz thinks is just terrific.
Mm.
The Charlie Chaplin classic Smile.
Smile. Aw.
He did silent films.
I bet he thanks his composer. I want to thank my ranger
smile,
for this.
Shut up. Though your heart is aching. Smile even though
while your crack is baking.
When there are clouds in the sky.
Ah, right.
See, he can smile.
Yeah, who cares about clouds in the sky? It doesn't bother me. I still get blown. Fucking jerk. And sorrow.
Rod Stewart laughs at him.
Forever. I'm ripping off Bruce Springsteen in Jersey.
Ugh. Why do actors do that shit? Why? Stick to the one thing you're good at.
They all want to be. Everyone wants to be a rock star. Yeah. That's the bottom line. Rock stars have the job everyone wants.
That's it.
Everyone wants to be a rock star.
And then they want to be actors. Rock stars want to be actors. Nobody wants to be what they are.
That's true. But rock stars can always say they're rock stars, you know? Yeah. So this guy, I've had some pain and hurt in my life. Let me jot it down and put it to some music, and the people are going to love it. No, they won't.
Hey, big hand there. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
I've been thinking of putting out an album myself. Me and my wife, what's her wacky name?
Mavis.
Mavis.
Mavis, your arm's like a cactus angel. I'm gonna sing a song. Hey, my head looks like a skunk. Hey, it's caused me pain half my life.
I don't laugh at Jay Leno jokes.
Of course you don't. Of course, you're waiting to get that. Jimmy Norton.
They called me again.
They did.
It's all, but only as a possible standby. They're like, for New Year's Eve, they're like, are you
a standby on New Year's Eve?
No, just to get a veil, just to get a veil. Not nothing. They're probably calling like 10, 15 guys.
Yeah.
To see. But it was just,
that's pretty cool.
It was still nice to get the call.
Farrow, what's up?
I just want to give you guys shit for playing some ass play and then playing this crap. Now I want to stab out my ears with a pencil.
I know, that's the beauty of the show.
Ice pick.
Pencil. That's the beauty of the show, though. We could go from ass effing to bad music.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
We're that talented.
You fell in love with a broken show.